NFL teams occasionally experience buyer's remorse in free agency. Unfortunately, most of these signings came with a no refund tag. If every NFL team had a mulligan on one regrettable free agent signing, we think we know who they'd like to use it on. Here's a look at the worst signings in every NFL team's history. At TPS, we post videos every single day, so don't forget to click the subscribe button to subscribe. Then click the notification bell to be notified when we post a new video. Arizona Cardinals' Dwayne Starks. Starks won a Super Bowl 35 championship with the Baltimore Ravens in the 2000 season, but he was never a Pro Bowler. It didn't stop the Cardinals from giving the veteran cornerback a five-year deal worth $23 million in 2002 free agency. He was limited to just 10 games in his first season with Arizona, and an ACL tear forced him to miss the entire 2002 campaign. Starks had a solid bounce-back campaign in 2003, but was later traded to the New England Patriots. Atlanta Falcons' Dante Robinson. Robinson was solid but never an elite quarterback. The Falcons still handed him a mammoth six-year, $54 million contract during the 2010 offseason. Robinson quickly fell out of favor with the team because of his reckless style of play, racking up several fines for illegal hits. He lasted just three seasons before getting released midway through his six-year deal. Baltimore Ravens' Elvis Grbach. The Ravens handed him a five-year deal worth a whopping $30 million, coming off of a Pro Bowl season with the Kansas City Chiefs. He struggled in his lone season with Baltimore, tossing just 15 touchdowns against 15 picks. He barely completed over half his pass attempts. The Ravens released him after 1 year, and he retired soon after. Buffalo Bills' Derek Dockery. Despite never earning a Pro Bowl or All-Pro selection in Washington, Dockery earned a life-changing payday from the Bills in 2007, inking a $49 million pact over 7 years. Dockery did nothing to help fix one of the league's worst offensive lines. Following two lackluster seasons, Buffalo released him in 2009, and he later returned to Washington for a second stint. Carolina Panthers' Chuck Smith. Looking to bolster their pass rush, the Panthers handed the Falcons star defensive end a five-year deal worth $21 million in the 2000 offseason. Unfortunately, knee injuries derailed Smith's career. He played just two games in 2000 before having to retire without getting the chance to prove himself. Chicago Bears' Mike Glennon. Even though Glennon was primarily a backup in Tampa Bay, the Bears curiously handed him a three-year deal worth $45 million in 2017. A month later, they drafted Mitch Trubisky with the number two selection. All the Bears got out of Glennon was four starts, three of which were losses. He had four touchdowns and five interceptions before losing the job to Trubisky. Cincinnati Bengals' Antonio Bryant. Bryant was just 1 year removed from a 1,000-yard season with the Buccaneers before he signed a four-year, $28 million contract with the usual budget-conscious Bengals in 2010. But he was hampered by a knee injury and couldn't get things going in practice. Before ever playing a snap for the Bengals, Bryant was released. He never played in the NFL again. Cleveland Browns' Jeff Garcia. A three-time Pro Bowler with the San Francisco 49ers, Garcia scored a four-year deal worth $25 million from the Browns in 2004. It was a massive waste of money. Garcia lost 7 of 10 starts and had just 10 touchdowns against 9 interceptions and was released after just one season. Dallas Cowboys' Mike Vanderjagt. In 2006 free agency, the Colts replaced their Pro Bowl kicker with the GOAT Adam Vinatieri. Vanderjagt signed a three-year deal with the Cowboys worth $4.5 million. The contract included a $2.5 million signing bonus. He struggled making just 13 of 18 starts. Head coach Bill Parcells quickly gave up and released him late in the season, handing the starting job to veteran Martin Grammatica instead. Denver Broncos' Darryl Gardner. Here's another non-Pro Bowler who was just handed a baffling contract. The Broncos gave the veteran defensive tackle a seven-year deal worth approximately $35 million in 2003 free agency. Gardner was suspended by the Broncos for publicly calling out head coach Mike Shanahan on radio. He lasted just five games before eventually being released. Detroit Lions' Scott Mitchell. After serving as Dan Marino's backup in Miami, he landed a starting job with the Lions in 1994 by signing a three-year pact worth $11 million. That was a lot of money back then. Mitchell struggled in his five seasons with the Lions, going 27-30 as a starter with 79 touchdowns and 57 interceptions. Not awful, but simply not worth all that money. Green Bay Packers' Joe Johnson. The Packers couldn't pass on two-time Pro Bowl defensive end Joe Johnson. In 2002, he left the New Orleans Saints and signed a massive six-year deal worth $33 million. Injuries limited Johnson to just 11 games in two seasons with the Packers. He only posted two sacks in those games before getting released in 2004. Johnson never played in the NFL again. Houston Texans' Brock Osweiler. He performed well in Peyton Manning's absence for the Broncos during their Super Bowl 50 championship season in 2015. The reward? A mega four-year, $72 million contract from the Houston Texans. Osweiler struggled and completed just 59% of his passes for 15 touchdowns and 16 interceptions. The Texans were so desperate to get out of the $72 million mistake after 1 year that they gave the Browns second and sixth round draft selections just to take on his contract. Osweiler was released by the Browns before ever playing a snap for them. Indianapolis Colts Andre Johnson. The Colts signed the seven-time Pro Bowl wideout away from the AFC South rival Texans in 2015. Johnson agreed to a three-year deal worth $21 million, and the Colts were immediately pegged as a Super Bowl contender. But Johnson never found his groove on a Colts team that played below expectations. He caught just 41 passes for 503 yards and 4 touchdowns and was released after one season. Jacksonville Jaguars Bryce Popp. The four-time Pro Bowler was a game-wrecking force for the Packers and Bills. Popp finally scored his big payday in 98 when the Jaguars handed him a six-year deal worth a cool $22 million. But Popp couldn't continue his star-like production in Duval County. He had just 7.5 sacks in his two seasons with Jacksonville, and the team ultimately released him in 2000. Kansas City Chiefs' Kendrell Bell. The 2001 Defensive Player of the Year signed a seven-year deal with the Chiefs in 2005. It was reportedly worth over $5 million annually, and the deal included $10 million in guarantees. In three seasons with the Chiefs, Bell recorded just 2.5 sacks and failed to make much of an impact. He was rarely used in his final season with the team, and KC cut ties with him after the 2007 campaign. Las Vegas Raiders' Javon Walker. Looking to improve the offense around Jamarcus Russell, the Raiders handed the former Packers Pro Bowl receiver a giant six-year contract worth $55 million. The deal made little sense when he was coming off of an unproductive 2007 campaign with the Broncos. Injuries limited Walker to 11 games with the Raiders. He totaled just 15 catches for 196 yards and a touchdown. Los Angeles Chargers' David Boston. After emerging as a star in Arizona, Boston signed a monster seven-year deal worth $47 million with the Chargers in 2003. Boston performed well with 70 catches for 880 yards and 7 touchdowns, but he butted heads with Chargers coaches and his personality quickly became too much for them to deal with. He was traded to the Dolphins after just one season in San Diego. Los Angeles Rams' Drew Bennett. Bennett was a solid receiver in Tennessee, recording 700 or more yards three times. This included a 1,247-yard season in 2004. In 2007, the Rams handed Bennett a giant six-year contract worth $30 million. Bennett played just 15 games for the Rams over two seasons, recording 34 catches for 379 yards and three touchdowns. Miami Dolphins' Jabril Wilson. Coming off of a surprise AFC East division-winning season, the Dolphins looked to upgrade their defense. They signed veteran safety Jabril Wilson to a five-year deal worth $27.5 million. Even though he was never once a Pro Bowler or All-Pro, Wilson lasted one season in South Beach before the Dolphins decided to release him. Minnesota Vikings' Fred Smoot. After four solid years in Washington, Smoot landed a shiny six-year deal with the Vikings worth $34 million. Smoot's struggles led to him getting benched, and he was involved in the infamous Team Boat Crew scandal of 2005. The Vikings released him in 2007. New England Patriots' Adalius Thomas. The two-time Pro Bowl linebacker was a superstar on the Ravens' defense. Looking to improve an already dominant unit, Belichick handed Thomas a five-year deal worth $35 million. Thomas wasn't exactly terrible with 14.5 sacks over three seasons in Foxborough, but he never came close to living up to his contract. New Orleans Saints' Jairus Byrd. Coming off of his third Pro Bowl season with the Bills, Byrd landed a six-year deal worth $54 million with the Saints, one of the prime favorites in the NFC. But Burt's stint in Nolan was a letdown. He wasn't a fit in their defense, which was downright awful during his 3 years there. Despite his reputation as a ball hawker, Byrd struggled mightily in coverage and had just three picks as a Saint. New York Giants' LeVar Arrington. Arrington was one of the NFL's top linebackers during his time in Washington. The NFC East rival Giants managed to land Arrington on a seven-year deal worth $49 million in 2006 free agency. Arrington missed all but six games in 2006 due to an Achilles injury. The Giants released him in the ensuing offseason, and Arrington retired soon after. New York Jets' Tremaine Johnson. With an insane amount of cap space, the Jets went nuts in 2018 free agency and handed cornerback Tremaine Johnson a five-year deal worth $72.5 million. Johnson lasted just two seasons with the Jets. In 17 appearances, he allowed just 63 catches for 754 yards and three touchdowns in coverage. He was a major liability and an expensive one at that. Philadelphia Eagles' Ndamdi Asamoah. Widely regarded as the NFL's best cornerback, Asamoah was coming off of a third straight Pro Bowl season with the Raiders. The top free agent of 2011 joined the Eagles on a six-year deal worth $60 million. A signing made the Eagles a trendy pick to win the Super Bowl. But the two-time first-team All-Pro was a massive disappointment in Philly. He struggled in their defensive scheme and looked nothing like the shutdown corner the Eagles thought they were paying for. Philly released him after just 2 years. Pittsburgh Steelers' Ladarius Green. The Steelers have traditionally avoided big free agent signings, so we're nitpicking a bit here. In 2016, Pittsburgh handed the former Chargers tight end a four-year deal worth $20 million. Injuries limited him to just six games, and he only caught 18 passes, 304 yards, and one touchdown. The Steelers released Green in 2017, and he never played in the NFL again. The 49ers' Jonas Jennings. Despite never playing at a Pro Bowl level in Buffalo, Jennings managed to land a massive seven-year deal worth $36 million from the 49ers in 2005 free agency. The deal carried $12 million in bonus money, too. Injuries unfortunately limited Jennings to just 23 starts over four seasons in San Fran. They ultimately cut him after the 2008 campaign. Seattle Seahawks' Matt Flynn. Flynn was viewed as starting caliber thanks to one good start with the Packers in 2011 in a Week 17 game against Detroit where he racked up 480 passing yards and six touchdowns. The QB needy Seahawks signed Flynn to a three-year deal worth $26 million. The only problem? Some guy named Russell Wilson, drafted in the third round, won the starting job instead. Yeah, things turned out fine for Seattle, but it doesn't negate the fact that they overpaid for a guy who never started a game for them. Tampa Bay Buccaneers' Michael Johnson. A year removed from an 11.5 sack season with the Bengals, Johnson scored the big payday with Tampa Bay in 2014 free agency, agreeing to a five-year deal worth a hefty $43.75 million. Johnson recorded just four sacks for the 2014 campaign, and the Bucs gave up rather quickly. He was released after just 1 year, and Johnson wound up returning to the Bengals on a multi-year deal. Tennessee Titans' Deion Lewis. Lewis enjoyed a career year for the Patriots in 2017, rushing for 896 yards and six touchdowns that led him to cashing in with the Titans in free agency. Lewis signed a four-year contract worth $19.8 million, but the shifty running back failed to serve as a complimentary option to superstar Derrick Henry. In two seasons with the Titans, he totaled just 726 rushing yards, one TD, and 84 receptions for 564 yards and two touchdowns. Lewis was released following the 2019 season. Washington football team Albert Haynesworth. This is far and away the worst free agent signing in NFL history. The mercurial defensive tackle was a sought-after free agent in 2009. He turned down a more lucrative offer from Tampa and accepted a seven-year, $100 million deal with Washington. Haynesworth openly complained about the team's defensive schemes, was notably out of shape, and constantly clashed with coaches. This led to a suspension imposed by the team. Washington gave up on Haynesworth and traded him to the Patriots in 2011, where he'd be released mid-season. What do you think is the worst free agent signing in your favorite team's history? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you're new here and you haven't subscribed yet, now's a great time to do that by hitting that subscribe button down there. If you like the video, then like the video. We'd really appreciate it. And until next time, tune into TPS every single day for more cool videos. We'll see you.